What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Miss Sugar, from www.MissSugar.net, and you are now tuned in to the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. As opposed to saying, fix your wig, girl, in light of one of my longtime Judies who decided to betray me on social media, I'm gonna say, fix your loyalty, bitch. Fix your motherfucking loyalty. Wonka wonka motherfucking.
Well, thank you, Miss Sugar, for MissSugar.net. Okay, thank you for that very elegant, that very proper, that very classy intro. Yes, I can be classy too, honey. I'm a classy lady as well, honey. As I rub down my Betsy Johnson ring, honey, for Macy's, honey. I'm very classy, honey. Sister Patterson, can you fix your wig, girl? Okay? This is the classy show today. We are classy, honey. The hell we not, honey. You know, Miss Sugar, I thought you was classy, honey, until you said bitch, okay? As soon as you said bitch, that took away from all your classiness, honey, okay? That shows you just regular one of us mess here, okay? So welcome, you bitch. And thank you for that intro. And I don't know, you know, the young lady that betrayed you, you know, disloyed you, but fuck her, okay? This is 2013. We ain't got time for these unloyal meatballs, okay? So if you are unloyal meatball, fuck you. That's why I have no friends. That's why I stay to myself, because I just don't trust people, honey. I don't put trust in no human being. All my trust is in this dog right here named Sister Patterson, honey. A ruff, ruff, ruff. So, you know, shout out to you all out there who got a million of friends, and then you hang out with all, you know, a large group of people. You go out together and do a trust me, they all not loyal to you, believe me. There's going to be some dishonest members, okay? But I don't have that problem, because I stay to myself, honey, okay? So, I don't have new friends. I don't want new friends. Don't get me wrong, I have, you know, friends. Like, I have my peoples, like Dana and Crystal and Chinchilla. That's it, okay? You need to be able to count all your friends on one hand. If you need other people's hands to count your friends, you need to fix your life, honey. Fix your life, honey, okay? You don't need no more than 2 to 3 friends. That's about it, okay? If you got like 20, 30 friends, you need to fix your life, because there's something going on, okay? I don't do all that, okay? You know, I look at all these teenagers, all my peoples, my friends, da-da-da-da-da. Do you not realize when you hit at least 25, not even 25, maybe 21, after you leave high school, these same people, you ain't gonna have a thought about, okay? You need to just let these people be in your life. Stop being so quick to call people your friends, honey. I'm not quick to call somebody my friend, honey. You need to be in my life at least more than 5 years before I call you a friend, okay? That's just some thought of mine coming from an original OG, honey. Original old queen. Yes, honey, okay? So, you know, be careful who you call your friends. But again, Miss Sugar, from MissSugar.net, thank you for that very classy, aka messy intro. You guys, Miss Sugar, she's a blogger, slash radio personality, slash event host, slash media maven. And, you know, you can visit her, her website, MissSugar.net. And I just have to say, Miss Sugar, from visiting your site, I found out a little tea for myself and for the rest of you guys. Apparently, Miss Lawrence from the Real Housewives of Atlanta, that song he had called Closet Freak. You guys know I don't watch these. You know I don't watch TV at all. You know why you all watching these hip hop and Atlantas and hop and the Basketball Wives and Atlanta Housewives. Okay, I'm on YouTube watching 227 and Martin and the Wayne Brothers and the Parkers. Okay, I like, you know, shows that we know was scripted. I can't do these reality shows that they try to front like it's real life, but reality is scripted, honey, okay? So I need to know I'm watching a scripted show. But anyway, why you all watching all these? Anyway, I went to Miss Sugar's site and I found out that apparently the song that, I don't know if this is new, old, or what, but I'm just finding about it, so it's new to me, that the song Closet Freak that Miss Lawrence did, well, apparently, honey, he didn't get his coins. He did not get his coins. According to Miss Sugar, what? Who's, relax, my cell phone is going off. According to MissSugar.net, Miss Lawrence wants to know why his royalty check has not been cut yet, okay? Miss Lawrence is claiming that Candy has failed to pay him for work on the song that the two recorded. Speaking on the matter, he also said that there was some type of agreement, to share the split earnings for the song Closet Freak, which appeared on the episode of The Real Housewives of Atlanta sometime last year. Anyway, however, Lawrence is saying that the promised funds were never deposited into his account. It's not an issue, you know. I ain't seen no money, okay? I don't get quiet, honey. I speaks on a matter, okay? Lawrence said, you know, I didn't leave Candy. We had a split. You know, ain't nothing come between us but a split. Truth be told, he just said he didn't get his coins. He wouldn't know where his coins at. So Candy then got on her Twitter, okay, and said Closet Freak didn't sell hardly enough any copies, okay? There was nothing left after paying the producer and recouping what I paid for the studio time in a mixed fees. So you ain't getting no coins. Apparently, you know, I guess this dude didn't get, Lawrence didn't get his coins, okay? I don't know, because you know I don't watch these shows, but apparently he didn't get the coins for the Closet Free and this, that, and that. But I have to say something about you, Candy. Candy is always so quick to get on her Twitter page and go off. I don't blame her. You know, once you gotta set the record straight, why not get on your Twitter? Twitter's like the number way to communicate nowadays. So yesterday I was on MediaTakeOut.com, you guys. I don't know if you saw this on MediaTakeOut.com. And MediaTakeOut.com, you know I love you. You are my brother. You are my sister. You are my mother. You are my father. You give me to the world. Like, a lot of people, you all know me for MediaTakeOut.com. You know, I love them. But sometimes you just post stuff that just make me say, shut the hell up. And yesterday you post something that just made me say, really, MediaTakeOut.com, just because an openly gay dude is communicating with a straight dude, that doesn't make the straight dude gay, okay? I have a lot of straight male friends. Why? Because a straight man want to talk to me, he has to be gay. Apparently, this dude named Ridiculous, he's some sort of stripper from Atlanta. Here he is right here, okay? He's a butterface. Everything looks good but that face, honey. So he's, you know, he's this openly bisexual stripper out in Atlanta, and he tweeted Todd is Candy's boyfriend, and he said, hey I contact you. To me, I'm like, the way I read it is, hey, do I contact you? Hey, I contact you, meaning do I contact you for whatever it is, okay? Who's to say is implying that it's gay? MediaTakeOut, you make me sick, honey. Why every straight man that talks to a gay man has to be gay? Anyway, so Candy then gets on her Twitter page, and I hate when women have to come to a man's defense. Why are you coming to your man's defense, Candy? This is between MediaTakeOut.com, Ridiculous, and your man Todd. This ain't nothing about you, no, Candy. Anyway, she gets on her Twitter and goes, if you must know MediaTakeOut.com, Todd167 is helping me put together my ladies' night tour, and Ridiculous is performing. So basically, in a nutshell, this openly gay stripper is performing for some type of ladies' night. So there you have it. You know, it's not much to the story, but a lot of people were saying, why do you have to dispel this rumor? Don't get me wrong, Candy, you have an obsession with gay dudes, okay? Because apparently you was in love with Miss Lawrence. Okay, sometime last year. And then this, what's this funky diva, Mahi is late like, Fanny, you need to fix your wig, girl, and fix your loyalty, bitch. Just like Miss Sugar said, who is you loyal to, bitch? Is it, Lawrence, or is it, Miss Funky Diva, Funky Don, whatever his name is, until you find, like, some new gay guy is hot out there. I don't know, you guys. All I have to say is I don't think this man is gay. I think Ridiculous was just asking, who do I contact for this party? MediaTakeOut.com, you need to go sit down and take you a nap, honey, okay? Why must every straight man talk to every gay man? Gotta be gay, honey. That's what's wrong with this world now, honey, okay? So, but Candy, you know, you need to fix yourself, girl, because I think you may have a little something in your, you know, your little situation, honey. I don't know what you all think. I just find it hilarious. I'm really upset with MediaTakeOut.com, but I don't know. But to you, Ridiculous, you ain't that sexy, okay? And I don't get you females who get off by watching openly gay man strip. Does that turn you on, my straight females out there, knowing that this man is bisexual or gay, he's stripping for you? Do your coochie get wet, honey? Because me being a straight female, if I know this man, you know, slinging his dingling on my face, that he like a male booty hole, male pussy, it's not gonna get me wet, okay? I need a man, you know, you could be gay, but don't let me know. This man lets you know, Ridiculous lets you know, yo, I'm bisexual. That ain't gonna turn my pussy on. Hell no, bitch. I need me a man, honey. A real man. I don't care if he's gay. I just don't want to know he's gay. But this motherfucker out here stripping, get that thing out my face. Smelling like ass, honey. Hell no. All right, moving on. But again, thank you, Miss Sugar. Candy, you know, you need to fix your loyalty, bitch, okay? You with Funky Diva. Let's see who you gonna be with next year, bitch. Me, bitch. All right, you know how I be, bitch. Let's see, you guys. Moving on. I have, again, something else, Candy, they were saying about you. This is just, you know, I'm just a gossip person. That you like to lurch off single, lonely women with your adult toys, okay? And you want to give off all these little strip shows to these women who ain't got no man, bitch. But hey, I'm not knocking your hustle, bitch. Get your coins, bitch. If this is where you gonna make your money at, bitch, get it. These lonely single women ain't got no man, and they want you to, bitch, get them coins, okay? But again, ladies, I'd rather, this is for my single ladies. Sister Patterson, I don't know if you single or what, but I'd rather be single than to be with a man who may be gay, and I know, but I'm just putting on a front to the world because the show I got me a man. I'm not saying nothing, Candy, but if you look at Todd, honey, okay, yeah, Ridiculous, yeah, you want to contact him for what? moving on. Now listen, you guys, I have a great show planned for you all. Damn, that took up 12 minutes. Listen, I have a good show planned. We have the I can't, and I won't. Let me tell you something. The I can't, and I won't today is on fire. Did you hear about Pebbles, the model? She was arrested in a whole butt enhancement death. And the original, the person who does the procedure, no. Wait till I show you this picture, honey. You was gonna gag. I wanna know if you will let this person put some, enhance your booty from that face. You just stay here. Plus we have your celebrity team, Diana Ross. We has to talk about you, Diana Ross, honey, okay? It's about time that these people put these celebrities in their place. Diana, I must read you, honey. And I know you know older, while I like to respect my elders, but honey, sometimes you elder people need a read to bring you back down. And not only that, but you are a celebrity. Sometimes you celebrities need a good read to bring you back down to reality, honey. You are not God. We will get into that later in the show. Apparently she gonna walk into some restaurant. I am Diana Ross, okay? You better sit me down. I ain't waiting on nobody's line, honey. We're gonna read her. And I have another contestant from the Loving It or Come Again, and it's Nicki Minaj boyfriend, honey, SB, aka Scaff Beezy, and he has a song called High Beans. High Beans. We're gonna check that out. I like it. You know, it took me a while, but we'll talk later in the show. And and some other things. So you're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Before we get into all of that, you know I like to get to the quickie. Okay, the quickie, honey. If you want to send me a quickie, if you want to open up the show, bimbowinehouse@gmail.com is the email. But this quickie comes from a young man, and apparently he does not know if he's gay, bi, or curious. And relax, here's the email. Let me have a sip of my sweet bitch. Nah, this is liquor. I just call it sweet bitch because, I don't know, sweet bitch. Alright, this comes from Dave. You guys ready? Alright. Dear Bimbo, I thought I finally got what I always wanted, but now I'm more confused than ever. Bimbo, I am 25 years old, a grad student, and I've been with my current girlfriend for 3 years. I love her with all my heart. She is the yin to my yang. I really do see myself being with her for the rest of my life, and that means, yes, I'm ready to walk down the aisle with her. But it's something that I always knew about myself, and it was that I was attracted to dudes as well. I had these urges for as long as I can remember, but I never act on them until Christmas Eve, 3 days ago. So I went home to visit my family in Ohio, and I stayed at a hotel around the corner because too many out-of-town relatives were staying at my parents' house already. Anyways, I was watching your show on Christmas Eve. Thanks for the upload. And I said, well, I had these urges, then what better time to act on it than now? I didn't know where to start, so I just Google search meet guys in local area. And Craigslist came up, so I posted a message on what I was looking for. Even though I am black, I am only attracted to white dudes. Really, well, hot twinks looking white dudes. So I posted a picture of my chest and status. 25 year old, 167 pounds, swimmer's build, and a 9-inch dick. I would send you a pitch, but you might forget about the email and draw all over my dick. Excuse me, Dave, you can send me a picture of your dick and you ain't gonna see no type of drooling or nothing, okay? Because first of all, you like white men, honey, okay? This is a black ass. You ain't gonna know what to do with this. Okay, but send that pitch, bimbowinehouse@gmail. Back to the email. Where we at? Oh, anyways, I wasn't expecting any responses, but incoming messages started coming like hotcakes. So fast forward, I connected with a guy that caught my eye. And Bimbo, he was a cute 19-year-old white dude who was a bottom with a fat ass. So he came to my hotel room, and at first, I was very nervous because this was the first time I was about to do something with a guy, and since that, I was nervous. But then Bimbo, he came over to where I was sitting and jumped on me and started French kissing the hell out of me. And Bimbo, he kissed me on stops. I never knew existed, but I wasn't excited yet. Then he started kissing my chest all the way down to my pants. Then he removed them and started sucking my dick. But Bimbo, I wasn't hard or excited yet. He asked me to suck his dick, and I said, okay, I'll try, but I only did it for like 5 minutes because it wasn't my thing. I could tell he enjoyed it, but I found it disgusting and nasty. Speak for yourself, honey. Anyway, he asked, could I fuck the shit out of him? And Bimbo, I wore his ass out, Bimbo. I had that bitch boy speaking in tongues, but I wasn't fully hard or that much excited. So after 2 hours of fucking, 2 hours? Oh, hell no. Okay, you get 20 minutes with me. Get out. I got things to do. I ain't got 2 hours to be fucking. Anyway, after 2 hours of fucking, he busted. After he left, I had to jack off to straight porn just to bust a nut. Because the dude just wasn't getting me hard. And all while I was with the dude, I was thinking about my girlfriend. I can honestly say that was my first gay experience. What I thought... wasn't what I, that was his first gay experience, and it wasn't what he thought it was going to be. And since I wasn't interested in him or the sex, I'm now confused or whatever. I'm really attracted to dudes in a sexual way, or if it's was me just experiencing for the first time. I don't see myself doing something like that again, but who knows? One thing I can say is that I'm in love with my girlfriend, and I'm ready to walk down the aisle. Well, Dave, we have to hurry up because we don't have that much time left in this quickie. But your question was, are you gay, bi, or curious? Well, you can cross out curious because you had sex with a dude, so you're not curious no more, okay? You done had it, bitch. But I do believe you're bi because you are still attracted to females. You know, you still think about your girlfriend. What I think it was for you in this whole sexual situation was you felt guilty. You felt like you was cheating on your girl. And the reason you had your girl on your mind is because you felt guilty. Secondly, this dude was white, honey, okay? Had you would have been up in this, that dick would have been fully erected, okay? You would have bust a good nut, okay? You're bisexual. I don't think these gay feelings is going to go away. I think what you're trying to do is you're trying to get married. You're trying to be with this girl to get the thoughts out your mind. And get, you know, I'm straight. I got to be with a female. Them thoughts is never going to go away. You know what I mean? Men who are gay and scared to know that they're gay and try to, you know, don't act on it and whatnot. And they try to get married and try to live the whole straight life. Eventually, them gay feelings is going to come back creeping up on you. What I think you need to do is tell this young lady before you marry her that you are bisexual. You have feelings for dudes, okay? It's only right. Before you get this lady, before you get this girl who, which I know you're not, because I know too many men that's married and they just do it on the down low, okay? They deceive these women to believing that they're really straight. In reality, they're gay. This is what you're doing here. You're deceiving, making it to this female believe that you are 100% straight, and she don't know about this whole little situation right here that you had with this dude. And this is the problem with the world. You men, you are the men. And then it's the gays like me who get looked down on the world, but we are honest ones. We're the open ones. We the truth ones about who we truly are. I'm not coming down on you because, you know, you was open enough to send me this email, but all I'm saying is, you're bi, and I think you should tell her that you're bisexual, okay? These feelings are going to come back. You just ain't have the right dude to turn you out, okay? This little white dude didn't know what he was doing, honey, but like I said, if you get you a black ring, I'm gonna show you how you get turned out, baby. But, again, you asked me if he was gay, bi, curious, you're bi. If that was your question, there's my answer. If you guys have a different opinion for this young man, you be sure to leave it on the comments or email me, and I will try to get it back to him. But you still can send me a picture of your dick, honey. BibbleWhitehouse@gmail.com, and I promise you I won't drill. But wow. Remember, if you want to email me, it's BibbleWhitehouse@gmail.com, and I'll try to give you my best opinion. But all he asked was, is he gay, bi, or curious? He's bi. The curious part, he already did the sexual, it wasn't what he thought it was, because you ain't have the right man. Get you a black man, honey. These little white boys don't know what they doing, honey, when it comes to a black dick, okay? And then, that's what it is. Anyway, you guys, we have a good show planned up for you guys. Don't forget, I want to talk about Miss Diana Ross, okay, who she digs. She is the queen of every, Diana Ross, sit down. Plus, we're going to check out SB, that's Nicki Minaj's boyfriend. He has a song called High Beams, all that. But right now, we're about to get into the intro. When we come back from the intro, we're going to get into the I can't, and I won't segment. And baby, it's a good one. Stay tuned. You are checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Wonka, wonka, ew. Oh shit, here we go, oh shit, yes, you better dip it low, oh shit, yo, towel off on the dance floor. I don't give a fuck, I'ma take that dick and take it out my butt. I got a juicy ass and a big ass cock. I know this queen, I just won't stop. I'm not Korean, but I give super head. I'ma choke on that dick until I'm dead. I'm a nasty hoe, I'm a freak bitch. Come on, me boys, y'all watching that addiction shit. Ow! Yes! Dip it, dip it low. Ew! Ew, ew, ew. And break it up slow. Ow! Ow! Yes! Dip it low. Ow! And here we go. Alright, bitch, can we start the motherfucking show? Ow! Yes, baby! Alright, this is addiction show. Let's go. So we're back, guys, and let's get straight to it, honey. We got to get straight to the I can't, and I won't segment. A lot of you all have been loving this segment. So here's a few stories and a few pictures. Now, you guys know I do not watch these reality shows. I tell you, I love my 227, my A-Man, my Martin, my DeParkers. But apparently, on The Real Housewives of Atlanta, one of the last recent episodes, Kenya Moore made a very daring statement. Somewhere around these words, she goes, every day someone is mistaking her for being Beyonce.
Are you crazy? Are you crazy? Okay.
And now, Shenanay, calm down, calm it down, honey, okay? You know, we all, some people out here think that they look so like someone, okay? People sometimes say I look like Trey Songz. Do I give you Trey Songz in the face, honey? Look at me. Do I give you Trey Songz in the body, honey? Do I give you Trey Songz in the voice? Ooh, oh, oh, I invented sex. I invented sex. I invented sex.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
All right, Sweet Brown. Okay, relax, honey. Relax, Sweet Brown. Okay, nobody got time for you, honey. Okay, don't want me to tell you who people say you look like, Sweet Brown. Okay, so you better. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for you, bitch. Now listen. Moving on. Speaking of Shenanay, I needs to know who aunt is this? Who aunt is this right here? Who told your aunt to come out looking like this? Like, you know, I know, you all know I'm all for wearing what you want and doing what you want. But there's some things that should not be worn to certain people that just look nasty. And you wonder why some of these men, straight men out here, mess with trannies and drag queens before. Why would they want to mess with that shit right there, okay? This is exactly why they come to drag queens and trannies, because we be having our shit on point, honey. That shit right there, honey, that look like something Flavor Flav shit out, honey. You need to fix yourself, bitch. That is just messy. Also moving on, I can't and I won't. Listen, also moving on with the I can't, I won't segment. You all know I love saggers. I love saggers, okay? I love, you all talk about pull your pants up. No, they need to put them down more, okay? If you sag, no, show that ass, because there's people like me who love it. Now, there are some people who should not sag. There's some dudes who should not sag. For example, this dude right here. That, okay, shout out to my friend Julius, who captured this picture inside Walmart or Target somewhere. Some dude was sagging, and he bent down to, I guess, get a shirt. And all you can see is shit stains and a crack of that ass. Now, that is just disgusting, okay? If you are going to sag, this is an important message to you all saggers. If you're going to sag, please have on clean drawers, okay? That is just nasty. And then you have on white drawers, okay? If you don't want, you know, clean your ass, at least wear black drawers where they can blend in with the black. But that is just disgusting, honey. And then he had it all the way down, just nasty, honey. Now, lastly, before we go, I have one more story for the I can't, and I won't segment. Okay, I have a serious question for you all who want to get butt implants and butt injections. Would you let this right here give you butt injections? Yes, right now, would you let this, whatever that is, give you butt injections? My answer, hell to the no. Okay, I will let my ass be flat as a pancake before I let that shit right there. Ain't no way in hell. Well, anyway, his / her name is Morris Gardner. And this, all right, let me just give you the full story. This is from SandraRose.com. You all heard about the model who died. What was her name? Karima Gordon. She was 37. And she died after undergoing a legal procedure at the Mississippi home of this street doctor, Morris Gardner, who's 52. And apparently, Morris is ratting out Pebbles, the model. All right, here's the story. The woman known as Pebbles the model was captured in Memphis and charged with illegally brokering a buttshot procedure that resulted in the death of an Atlanta woman. Karima Gordon, 37, died after she was undergoing a legal procedure at the Mississippi home of this dude. Yes, that's a man. That's a tranny gone wrong, who is not legally licensed to perform such procedures. Police arrested Gardner on April 6, 2012, last year, and charged him with depraved heart murder after Gordon's autopsy revealed that she had her butt injected with semen and other substances. A depraved heart murder, which is also known as a depraved indifference murder, is a legal term for a crime that demonstrates a callous disregard for human life and results in death. The charge carries a life sentence. After Gardner was arrested, he named Pebbles the model, this young lady right here, as his go-to person for the woman who needed his assist in his illegal services. Pebbles' real name, Natasha Stewart, was arrested on January 3rd of this year, 2013, and charged with being a fugitive from justice in connection with Gordon's death. Police also took some other young lady into custody. It's not clear what role she played in Gordon's death, but both women are being held at the Shelby County Jail without bond. According to the Associated Press, Gordon met Pebbles in New York and paid her $200 for the referral to Gardner. The Associated Press located a Twitter page maintained by Karima Jordan with only one tweet sent out to the username Pebbles the Model. Pebbles the Model Twitter page, her page features photos advertising Gardner's work. That's the man, tranny. The photos show Pebbles with deformed buttocks and hips consistent with butt shots or butt implants. Blase. It's just so much. I can't and I won't. I have no response. I do have a response. First of all, I'm not letting this right here do any type of work to me, honey, okay? Until you fix your face, okay? Secondly, what is wrong with you young ladies with these? I blame you, Nicki Minaj, okay? You and that fake ass. You got all these young ladies with no booty, aka they have booty that they was born with. They just want to feel like they need to look like you, Nicki Minaj. Secondly, what kills me is that these girls get these big old butts for these men to attract these men. What you fella realize is that you got this big ass butt, you are attracting this man, but yet and still there's another female who ain't got no butt, she's attracting the same man. You do all this to get men, but you don't realize you can have that ass, you don't have to have no ass, honey. A man is gonna want you, he's gonna want you, period, honey, okay? Furthermore, it's just really getting out of hand with these fake asses, because this is what the world is glamorizing. This is what you need to look like. You need to have a fake butt. You need to have blonde hair. You need to bleach your skin. You need to have blue contacts. You need to this, that, and that. It's just too much. Let me tell you, young ladies out there, you need to love yourself, honey. If you look in the mirror and you are pleased with what you look like, that is all that matters. If a man is going to want you, he's going to want you, honey. These girls walking around with these fake booties, fake this, fake that, believe me, they are not happy, okay? Because don't get me wrong, sometimes I look at some of these females because I'm a tranny, I be jealous because I want to look like that, but in reality, these girls ain't happy, okay? Because you was not happy, you was happy, you wouldn't have this fake ass. I I don't mind implants. You know, do what you gotta do. But when your ass is that extreme, that you need help, honey. You need help. You really need help. That's just sickening. Cause you don't realize these same dudes that you fucking, I'm fucking too, honey. She's fucking too. So you can have all this fake that. These same dudes is gonna fuck a little no flatty flat. You may get more attention, but at the end of the day, they can get it too. So it's just so much going on. I don't know what's going on. But apparently the tranny's in jail, Pebble's in jail, but my thing is, what happens to the ass? Now that you're in jail, you can't keep getting your shots or whatever you do. It's gonna bloop, 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 bloop. It's over, bitch. I just, you know. But you know, get your implants, okay? If you got small tits, if God put them fake implants, get them, bitch. Make them titties bigger, you know. But some people just go to the extreme. But if it makes you happy, I'm happy. But I'll be the first to tell you, that is a cry for insecurity. If you got to do that much work to yourself, that is self-hatred. Just like Little Kim. Little Kim did all that work. That was a fine young... I don't hate on her. People say I go hard on Little Kim. Just shut up, okay? Shut up. What you want me? Be like, you, I love Little Kim. I love Little Kim. I love her. Shut the hell up. Little Kim was a little... She's still cute, but she went overboard with that surgery, honey. Black girl gone... Black girl lost. You know, it's sad. And the sad part, these people that does these procedures, they don't do nothing to themselves, okay? All these doctors, yes, come to my office and get your face done and get that. They ain't done no work on themselves, but they want to fix you. They just want that money, honey. You got to be careful with these, but don't get me wrong, I want them. But before I ever get the injections or whatever, I'll get the injections, the shot. I'm not getting no semen in my ass. And then you gonna let something like that put something in your ass? I can't, I won't. Moving on, you guys. So that was the I can't, I won't. We have to move on to the celebrity gossip. Celebrity tea. I hate that. So here's the celebrity tea, and it's hot, honey. It's hot. You better drink it slow, bitch. Drink it slow. You guys, I could not wait to come and talk about Miss Diana Ross. I don't know if you guys heard, but Diana Ross, she threw a tantrum at a Beverly Hills restaurant after they refused to serve her for cutting the line. Here is the story. Diana Ross, I hope somebody is watching from your camp and show you this video, honey, okay? Because they ain't gonna get no realer than this right here, bitch. Okay, this is from the page 6. Diva Diana Ross threw a supreme hissy fit at a restaurant, La Sakala in Beverly Hills, after she was not allowed to sit at a table until her daughter showed up. The Tony Italian Eatery has a policy of not sitting parties unless someone has reservations. So Diana didn't have reservations, she just showed up to the restaurant. According to witnesses, Ross arrived there for lunch Thursday afternoon ahead of her daughter. She didn't ask to be seated, but was denied. But Ross marched to a corner booth anyway. We're told management then came over to explain their seating policy and said that if she cut the line and sat before her daughter arrived, she would not be served. But Ross did not budge. Sources said that when her daughter arrived, a scene emerged and both women stormed out of the restaurant. La Sakala owner Gigi Leon told us, "I'm sorry that Miss Ross had a problem with that, and she feels that the rules don't apply to her. Our policy is that we don't sit incomplete parties until all the parties has arrived. If people jump the line, our policy is we do not serve them." And she was told that we treat everyone the same, whether you are famous or not. Can I repeat that? I love that line. We treat everyone the same, whether you are famous or not. We love having her as a customer. We'll be happy to have her back. A rep for Diana Ross didn't get back to us. Yeah, damn right they didn't get back, because they know Diana Ross is 100% wrong. Let me just give a shout out to that restaurant. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, I'm glad that, you know, we starting to give some of these celebrities reality. You are not God. I don't give a fuck if you are the motherfucking president. If my store policy tells you, you cannot be seated unless you have reservations. If you just coming up in the store trying to get online, you must wait online like everybody else. That's what's wrong with you celebrities. You think you are better. You are not better. You are just like the rest of us human beings. I'm glad that this restaurant, I mean, I respect Diane. You know, she gave me, I'm coming now. But understand something, bitch. You are just like the rest of us. I don't care who you are. You don't make you better. You shit like us, cry like us, and you spaz out like us. Do you agree or you disagree? Because I feel like I don't care who you are, okay? If my store policy tell you, honey, you have to wait, you have to wait. I don't care who you are, okay? I'm glad that these people is starting to get down on the celebrities, okay? Because these celebrities think they are almighty God. You are not mighty God, honey, okay? I work just like you. I don't care what you do, bitch. I don't care how famous you are. You are going to wait on this line. Sit down or get out. Now moving on. I'm sorry, I don't care if my grandma gotta wait, okay, on this line until I get there. Diana Rush, you gotta wait until y'all, whoever get there, bitch. That's the way it goes, bitch. You don't like it, go to somewhere and eat, bitch. Go somewhere else. I even know Diana Rush comes out the house, because they said Diana Rush like this. She's like me, she like to sit in the house all day. And she only go out when she had to go out. Moving on. According to Sandra Rose, honey, they are saying that Lala Vaquez is back on the market, honey, and that she is a lesbian. This is according to SandraRose.com. Listen, don't ask me how I know, but reality star Lala Vaquez and her New York Knicks husband, Carmelo Anthony, are headed for divorce court. Friends say Lala has been living the life of a single woman after separating from her man, her husband, last year. Insiders say Lala is keeping herself busy by focusing all attention on her son Kyan and filming the third season of her reality show Lala's Full Court Life, which premieres in February. Lala recently returned to her old stomping grounds in Atlanta, and the tongues were wagging about a certain chick and Lala's entourage who she couldn't take her hands, well, she couldn't take her eyes off. Hands, eyes, all the same shit. Then Lala jetted off to Miami, where she is in her. Then Lala jetted off to Miami, where she brung in a new year without her husband. Okay, yeah, it's definitely something going on, because you don't bring in the new year without your significant other, honey. Inside it say Lala and Melo are courteous to each other for the sake of their son. And they still go out in public together to keep up the appearances. But apparently, Lala has moved on with Melo's blessing. And I believe it. Because I tell you, them couples who act like their life is all perfect. Lala and Carl, you was one of them couples. Lala, you made it seem like you had the perfect life, honey. Behind every perfect, there is truly some drama. Like Keisha Cole and her boo, Gibson. Whatever. They try to seem like they have, hey boo boo on Twitter, I love you boo boo, come home. Oh please, there's something really going on behind that, okay? Don't do that. Don't do that. Like Nick Cannon and Mariah Carey love. Oh, I believe they love, because you see them fighting on Twitter, you see this, that. But I just hate couples who front. No one is perfect. Stop trying to act like you have the perfect relationship. You don't, honey, okay? You know what's really going on. I cannot stand people on Facebook. Oh, I love my boo boo, this, oh, shut up, okay? Tell me when he cheated on you, bitch. Give us some real life drama. Stop trying to act like you are perfect, because you are not perfect. Now, moving on. Speaking of couples, what are we talking about? Oh, speaking of couples, apparently Rihanna has had enough of Chris Brown. MediaTakeOut.com is reporting, hooray, it looks like Rihanna may finally be done with Chris Brown fuckery. She posted a goodbye letter after Brizzy and Kay came out together. Who is calling me? I am recording a show, honey. Sister Patterson, why didn't you turn off these phones? Got one pori texting me, when you gonna let me suck your toes? Got this motherfucking calling me. Listen, the other night, Rihanna and Karrueche were all up in the same club with Chris Brown, and everyone was talking about that, this, that, yada, yada. Anyway, Rihanna said enough is enough, and she now has posted a goodbye letter via Instagram. There comes a time in life when you walk away from all the drama and the people who create it, surround yourself with people who make you laugh. Forget the bad and focus on the good. Love the people who treat you right. Pray for the ones who don't. Life is too short to be anything but happy. Falling down is a part of life. Getting back up is living. Oh, Whitney Houston, shut up, bitch. You's gonna be right back with Bobby next week, honey. Oh, bitch, you can take that shit and fix your note, bitch, okay? Women kill me. They do all this stuff, get up on, you know, Facebook, Twitter. I'm done with him. I can't stand him calling their girlfriends. Girl, I'm done with him, girl. Calling family members. The next week, you'll see him right back with him. Bitch, please. You wanna impress me, Rihanna? I'm gonna need to see a good month of pictures without you and Chris Brown. And then from there, I need to see a good 3 months. And then from there, I need to see a good 6 months. Then from there, I need to see a year. Then from there, I need to 5 years. It's gonna take me 5 years to believe that you are done with Chris Brown, honey. Okay? So you can post all this because you mad today because you see that he's still fucking Karrueche. I've been telling you all, what y'all all need to do is just have menage a trois. Okay? You suck his dick while she eating your pussy, and then y'all take turns and let him fuck you. Just come on, we don't care. Have fun, okay? Don't be sitting here stressing over this crackhead. I'm convinced y'all Chris Brown is a crackhead. Have you seen the pictures of him? He looks straight up on crack or whatever. He's on coke, whatever. You look like shit. I think I'm going to take back that New Year's resolution, honey, okay? I'm not sucking no crackhead dick, honey, okay? I need to make it my prerogative to find another celebrity dick I want to suck before that. Y'all need to help me. Who else dick should I suck? Trey Songz. He look like a bottom. He look like he like his ass eating. I don't know. I like the Little Romeo, but Little Romeo seems so like preppy. Okay, I need a little hood in you. I really don't like that many people. Oh hell, Chris Brown, if I have to. You'll be the only crackhead dick I ever suck. What am I talking, y'all? Are you laughing? This show is a mess. Oh shit. Have you ever sucked a crackhead dick? Oh shit. Have a crackhead ever sucked your dick for like $5? Alright, listen. Moving on. What else are we talking? Oh, Beyonce. Oh, here we go. Real quick, because this is hilarious. We all going to have the same response, unless you are true Beyonce stan. This is hilarious. Really, Beyonce. Beyonce is considering a surrogate for her second pregnancy. Inside this claim, Beyonce and Jay-Z are ready for a sibling for their daughter Blue Ivory, but are considering a surrogate for their second pregnancy. From the Globe magazine, a source tells me Beyonce and hubby Jay-Z are anxious to add to their family. It's something they both talk about at length, reveals the insider. Beyonce wants Blue Ivory to have a brother or sister to play with, but at this point, she's not sure she's ready to put her body through another pregnancy. Are we all saying, pals say the pair are considering having a surrogate as an alternative. They consulted with top docs and searched out possible suitors to carry a second child, but haven't made a definite decision. This should have been I can't and I can't and I won't. We all are thinking the same thing here, okay? If you want to say it, you say it, but it's the obvious. Moving on. Alright, on a serious note, I mean, we all think the same thing about Beyonce, right? Okay, this would be the second time you have a surrogate, honey. Alright, listen. Oh, no, on a serious note, I asked you guys what did you want me to speak on. I really didn't want to speak on this, but this was like the number one thing you guys asked for me to speak on, so I'm going to speak on it. I don't know if you heard about Freddie O. Oh, excuse me, I mean Freddie E. Hey, Freddie O. Because when I first saw it, I said, oh no, Freddie O, he killed himself. But Freddie E. Freddie O is my friend from FreddieO.com. Hey, Freddie O. But rapper Freddie E, he committed suicide after venting on Twitter. And it was rumored that his girlfriend, Honey Cocaine, was to blame. let me just read this out. An extremely sad story of the underground hip-hop community. Seattle rapper Freddie E. was found dead Saturday, January 5th, from a self-inflicted gunshot wound and apparent suicide, according to confirmed reports. Freddie's family confirmed the sad news with a statement on Facebook posted shortly after the short originally exploded on Twitter. Our family is saddened beyond words. Our loss is great. The tragedy is enormous and unforeseen. The message read, not only our family, but the world has lost a talented, sensitive, brilliant young man who lit up our existence with his. Though he wasn't a household name, Freddie E. Born Frederick was best known for his highly successful YouTube channel, Jerk TV, which boasted over 7 million video views and more than 70,000 subscribers, and featured some of his comedy segments and original rap music. Before pulling the trigger on himself, the 22-year-old, who recently celebrated his birthday, took to the Twitter and vented about a situation apparently troubling him. And he goes, my day is ruined. Fuck my life. I'm about to delete Twitter in a second. This day can't get any worse. I'm sorry. I smoked my first pack of cigarettes today. It's been a long time since I've gone through heartbreak. It's a cold, unforgiving world, if I do say. It's all bad, y'all. Cruising in my 300 Chrysler, wishing the world would be a little brighter, but all I can seem to find is this lighter. It's bad, y'all. If there's a God, he's calling me back. He's calling me back home. This barrel never felt so good next to my dome. The gun never felt so good. Oh my God. It's cold, and I'd rather die than live alone. It's all bad. Puts finger around trigger. I love you, Mom. I love you, Dad. I love you, Catherine. God, please forgive me. I'm sorry, pal. I'm not going to get into the whole honey cocaine. No, okay? You can't blame someone's suicide on someone else. We don't know what this young man was going through, but I will say this. Why is it always the cuties that kill themselves? Okay? Why couldn't Rick Ross kill himself? I'm not trying to make a joke of the situation, but why all the cute guys gotta kill himself? He was fun, honey. Secondly, this is the difference between black people and white people. See, the black dude, he just killed himself. He said, I can't take it no more. Pow. On the other hand, a white person would have shot up a whole school, shot up a whole mall, shot up a whole playground, and then killed yourself. Right? That just shows you the difference between black and white. I'm not trying to make this a black and white thing, but if you want to kill yourself, and you all know I'm for suicide, if you're not happy in this world, do it. Kill yourself, okay? If you're not living a happy life, do it. I don't care. You all can disagree or agree. I don't care. If you are not happy in this world, bye. But, I just thank him for not killing honey. And then killing himself and killing his mother and killing, he just straight, bah, rest in peace, young man. Like I said, I'm all for suicide. If you are unhappy in this world, bye. But I've thought about suicide, you all know. I still think about suicide. But I must say, you all is what keeps me going, you know. I don't have a million subscribers, but the 5,000-6,000 of y'all, or, you know, whoever follow me on Twitter, Facebook, you all are what keeps me going. It's true. As long as you hear one person telling you to keep going, that's all you need, okay? And luckily, I have 1,000 of y'all telling me that. So I don't know if this young man had any support or which one, but rest in peace. And again, if you are not happy in this world, take your life. I'm all for suicide. I mean, you could disagree, agree, but if you're not happy, bye. You know, so rest in peace, Freddie E. And, my condolences is to the family. But just know this man is in a better place. He was not happy here. He went to go see the king. So, that's it. So, you know. All right, you guys. That's about it for the celebrity tea. Do I have time for a quick email? No, I ain't got time for no quick email. I'm sorry, honey. We'll get to that email tomorrow. But what are we doing? What are we doing? Oh, SB. We gotta get to his track called High Beings. But before that, it's time for your weird question of the day. Weird question of the day, Sister Patterson. Weird question of the day. Hey, weird question of the day. Weird question of the day. It's time for Sister Patty's weird question of the day. Oh, this is around the whole Diana Ross situation, honey. Do you think Diana Ross deserved to be seated because of who she was? Because she was known, she's a known celeb, she's a legend in some people's eyes. Or do you think she deserved the regular treatment? Okay, if you're not here with your full party, you have to wait just like everyone else. Or do you disagree? She's Diana Ross. She's a lab. She may cause, you know, craziness in the store. What do you say? You can email me at bimbowinehouse@gmail.com. We soon will get her email because these are your questions, so they're going to have to go to your email. Or you can leave a comment, okay? If you were to wait up, oh, Miss Ross, come on, honey. Or if, you know, Miss Ross, you have to wait, girl, okay? Just like everybody else. Miss Bimbo, is your full party here? All right, come on, let's go. Miss Ross, we'll be with you when your daughter get here. What do you say? Now, listen, before we go, we're going to get into the SB track. And the track is called, what is it called? High Beams. You all know SB is like Nicki Minaj hype man, aka boyfriend. But apparently, he wants to get some shine himself and, you know, come off with his solo career. He has a solo mixtape CD coming out called Clarity Mixtape vs. Clarity Volume 1 Brooklyn. Anyway, the track is called High Beams and this is the first single. Let me know what you think. Where's the track at? Wait. What? Aw, come on, don't do this to me. Wait, you guys, hold on. Really? Damn it. Really? I can't. One second, you guys. In the meantime, while I get this together, you can follow me on Twitter, Bimbo Winehouse, or friend me on Facebook, search Bimbo Winehouse. Alright, Bimbo Winehouse, baby. Here's the track right here. This is called High Beams. This is by SB. Nicki Minaj, boyfriend, and hype man. Let me know what you think of this track. Wait. Pause that. Real quick, if you have a submission for Loving It or Come Again, you need to email me, Bimbo Winehouse. Send me the link to the video or whatever, the song, whatever it is. And then also, I want to give a shout out to Alicia P. Apparently, a lot of people were feeling your track in Love Again, so I'm going to have the download for that in this video. So look below for Alicia P in Love Again and Tiffany Fox. Okay, girl, you need to come again because people was not feeling. You need to come again, girl. Anyway, this is SB. This is called iBeams. And let me know what you think. Let me know what you think, people. I'm so bright, high beams in the daytime. So bright, high beams in the daytime. I'm so bright, high beams in the daytime. So bright, high beams in the daytime. Light for me, light y'all, put it in the air like lights off. You can turn them down, but you can't turn these lights off. Light for me, light y'all, put it in the air like lights off. You can turn them down, but you can't turn these lights off. Wait, pause it. Okay. It took me about 10 times to hear this track to get into. I don't care. I like it. I don't care. I love it, honey. I don't know. You are the judge, though. Are you loving it or you come again, SB? Get into this track. We're going to start it again. Let me know what you think. I'm sorry, you all. I like it. It's something about this track. Get into it. Get into it!
I'm so bright, high beams in the daytime. So bright, high beams
in the daytime. I'm so high, high beams in the daytime.
You really don't want problems, that's bass off. I got these bitches bugging out.
Bass off. Alright, you guys, let me know what you think of this track. Apparently, I like it. Or man, I'm drunk. I think I'm drunk. Alright, you guys, we'll talk in the next show. I got to go, honey. 5 shows a week, remember. This is the first one of the week. Talk to you tomorrow. Bye.
Okay, now I ask me. Want a real diamond? You test me. Want to hit a block? Do you text me? You know that.